I've stopped having crushes on living things. It's just too much hard work. Now, I only fancy the dead. And at the moment, I'm a little bit in love with a rather marvellous Victorian gentleman called Captain Sir Richard Burton. Not to be confused with Elizabeth Taylor's fifth and sixth husbands. Burton was the first great anti-hero. Look at him. A great big army officer with stupendous moustaches, deep-set eyes, an eagle's brow, and big hands and feet, and we all know what that means. Or do we? Although he did eventually marry, his sexuality was always a subject of scandalous debate. What is certain is that he was fascinated by sex. He loved to watch it, and he loved to write about it. Burton was an explorer who famously failed to find the source of the Nile. But his lasting legacy is his exploration of a different kind. He didn't just lift the lid on sex in the British Empire, he jumped right in. Although his interpretations are still controversial, I want to see his world of eunuchs and brothels, of danger and disguise, for myself. He introduced to a prissy, uptight England the great erotic texts of the East, the Kama Sutra, Perfume Garden, and the Arabian Nights. Trouble with falling in love with a historical character is you can never get close enough. I want to see if I can find him, touch him, understand why this great Victorian maverick turned his back on convention and became, well, the godfather to the sexual revolution. And me.
Taxi!